हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईसीई एकेडमी बेनिफैक्टर। इन दिस क्लास विल बी सीइंग क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एम्पलीफायर्स बेस्ड ऑन द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इनपुट एंड आउटपुट इम्पीडेंसेस ऑफ एन एम्पलीफायर रिलेटिव टू द सोर्स एंड लोड इम्पीडेंसेस रेस्पेक्टिवली। वी कैन क्लासिफाई द एम्पलीफायर्स इंटू फोर ब्रॉड कैटेगरीज। Those are voltage amplifier, current amplifier, transconductance and transresistance amplifier. So in this class we'll be seeing voltage amplifier and current amplifier. In the next class we'll be seeing about transconductance and transresistance amplifier. This topic is from feedback amplifier unit and the subject name is electronic circuit analysis ECA. So let us start with voltage amplifier. So the voltage amplifier, this is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit of a voltage amplifier. If the amplifier input resistance RI is very very large compared to RS and the load resistance RL is very very large compared to R0, then we say this is a voltage amplifier. So how to draw a voltage amplifier? It's easy to understand. First we need to connect a voltage source, of Vs. So voltage will have a series resistance, so source resistance is Rs, Vs, Rs, the source resistance, okay. On the output side we are connecting a load resistor RL, where we are observing the output voltage. So at the input side voltage source with in source resistance RS and output voltage across RL. Now to draw a voltage amplifier we need this circuit, okay, this part is there. So how to remember it? Now for a voltage amplifier this RI value is very very large compared to RS, okay. So this point you need to remember. And then at the output side we are connecting a voltage AV VI. The voltage VI is across RI. So AV VI voltage we are connecting and then voltage we are having a series resistance R0. Okay. So RI voltage source AV VI with R0. What's the condition for a voltage amplifier? RI should be very very large compared to RS. If RI is very very large means it is an open circuit. If it is an open circuit what happens? VI is equal to VS. So here at the output side what's the condition? RL is very very large compared to R0. So RL becomes open circuit. So RL becomes open circuit means V0 is equal to AV VI. So V0 is approximately equal to AV VI. And what is VI equal to VS? So we can write V0 is approximately equal to AV VI, which is also equal to AV VS. So for a voltage amplifier, RI is very very large compared to RS. So what happens? VI becomes equal to VS. VI is approximately equal to VS. And at the output side RL is very very large compared to R0. So what happens? V0, this becomes open circuit. So V0 is approximately equal to VI and VI is approximately equal to VS. So from this we get an equation of voltage gain AV. AV is equal to V0 by VI. So what is output voltage? Output voltage is directly proportional to input voltage. So what is a voltage amplifier doing? It is enhancing the input voltage. Output voltage is directly proportional to input voltage. Such an amplifier circuit provides an output voltage proportional to the input voltage and the proportionality factor AV does not depend on the magnitude of source resistance and load resistance. Okay, so what is a voltage amplifier definition? voltage amplifier is an amplifier provides an output voltage proportional to input voltage where the proportionality factor is independent of source resistance and the load resistance. Hence this amplifier is called a voltage amplifier. So as a condition for an ideal voltage amplifier, practically Ri is very very large compared to Rs. Ri is very very large means ideally Ri value will be infinity. Large means infinity. At the output side, this RL is very very large compared to R0. RL is very very large compared to R0. So what is R0 value? Is very small. R0 value is very small. So R0 is 0. So for an ideal voltage amplifier, Ri is infinity and R0 is 0. For practical voltage amplifier, Ri is very very large compared to Rs and RL is very very large compared to R0. So this is how we can draw the voltage amplifier Thevenin circuit and define it. An amplifier whose output voltage is directly proportional to the input voltage and the proportionality factor does not depend on the magnitude of source and load resistance. Hence this amplifier is called a voltage amplifier. Let us now see the current amplifier. In voltage amplifier, what we are placing? A voltage source Vs and connecting a series resistor Rs. This is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit. At the output source voltage and resistance in series. In current amplifier, we need to place a current source. So a current source means Is. When we are having a current source, it is known as not an equivalent circuit of a current amplifier. So for a current source, a resistor will be in parallel. So Is is a source current, Rs is the source resistance or source resistor. So Is parallel with Rs, and this is a common circuit. This is for a current amplifier Ri, and we are placing a current here. So what is the value? Ai, Ii. And current means parallel to that resistor R0, and across RL we observe the output voltage as in the voltage amplifier we have done. So this part is common. In voltage amplifier RL parallel we are observing V0. Okay, so in current amplifier we are placing a current source, and at the output side also current with the parallel resistor. Current with parallel resistor, current with the parallel resistor Ri. And here the current Is, and this is the current Ii. Here the current I0 is equal to IL. We need to ground these two parts. Input circuit and the output circuits are to be grounded. So for a current amplifier, what is the condition? This current Ii should flow. So what should be the value? This resistor value should be very small. So Ri is very very small compared to this Rs. So this Ii flows through it. So when Ii is flowing through it, what we say? Ri is very very less compared to Rs. So what should be the ideal value of Ri? Very less means 0. So if the amplifier input resistance Ri is 0, if the input resistance Ri is 0, what will happen? Ii and Is becomes equal, approximately equal. Then Ii is approximately equal to Is. And what about the output resistance? For the output resistance, this Ai, Ii, this should be, so what will happen here? This RL, RL value should be very very small compared to this R0. Okay, RL value, if it is small, what will happen? The current I0 will flow through it. So what will happen? We can observe the output voltage. So it's only possible when RL value is very small. That is, in other words, we can say R0 value is very high. It should be high. So Ri is small and R0 is high. If R0 is high, what will happen? RL is small. If RL is small, what we can write? IL is equal to Ai, Ii. So IL is written as Ai, Ii. So what is IL equal to? IL is equal to I0. I0 is equal to Ai, Ii. So what is the current gain equation? AI is equal to I naught by II, which is known as current gain. Okay, so what is an ideal current amplifier must have? Zero input resistance Ri zero and infinite output resistance R naught. So and what is the definition of a current amplifier now? We can define it like this. An amplifier which provides an output current proportional to input current. An amplifier which provides an output current proportional to input current, where constant of proportionality is independent of source and load resistances. This is constant of proportionality. The constant of proportionality is independent of source and load resistance. Such amplifier is known as current amplifier. So let us again define a current amplifier in which the output current is proportional to input current and the constant of proportionality is independent of source and load resistance. Such an amplifier is known as current amplifier. So let us quickly summarize the voltage and current amplifier. Voltage amplifier means Thevenin circuit. We need to place a voltage source for current amplifier, Norton circuit, and we need to place a current source at the input side and output side. So what's the voltage amplifier gain equation? AV, voltage gain, output voltage by input voltage. Current gain for AI is equal to I naught by II, output current by input current. For ideal voltage amplifier, Ri is infinity, R naught is zero. Current amplifier, Ri is zero, R naught is infinity. Ri is infinity means Ri is very, very large compared to Rs. R naught is zero means RL is very, very large compared to R naught. Coming to current amplifier, Ri is zero. Ri is zero means Ri is very, very less compared to Rs. R naught is infinity. It means RL is very, very less compared to R naught. That is, R naught value is very high. Okay, so then these are the two basic amplifiers, voltage and current amplifier. In the next class, we'll be seeing about transconductance and transresistance amplifier. So, what's the voltage gain equation? AV is equal to V naught by VI, and current gain equation is I naught by II. So, what's the definition of a voltage and amplifier? An amplifier which produces an output voltage proportional to input voltage, where the constant of proportionality is independent of source and load resistance, is a voltage amplifier. Coming to current amplifier definition, an amplifier which produces an output current proportional to input current, where constant of proportionality is independent of source and load resistance, is known as current amplifier. I hope you have understood the class. If you have any queries, you can post in the comment section. Thank you. Good luck, students.